It's time to take a look at Noctua's flagship NH-D15 air cooler and see if it is really king of the hill. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Tech Yes City. This is Brian coming back to you guys today with a review of a very big air cooler. This is the NH-D15 from Noctua, and wow, this thing is huge. So we're gonna go run down through the specs first, then I'm gonna do a comparison against all the other coolers I have here, and then we'll go on to a conclusion and my subjective opinion about this cooler. So as soon as you get the box in, from start to finish, this thing was just a luxurious experience, if that's one word to put it. The box and everything in it comes organized so well, comes foam packaged. I couldn't ask for a better unboxing experience. Now, as soon as we pull the contents out, you've got their two low noise adapters. You've also got two 140 millimeter fans from Noctua themselves. So these are in-house designed fans, and boy, are they very quiet, but we'll get onto that later. They are sort of cream and brown themed there. Also included is mounting kits for popular AMD and Intel sockets. And another good thing I'll point out about Noctua is they include future compatibility. So all you have to do, if you get a new socket in the future and your cooler doesn't mount, you just send them an email and they'll send you out the attachments and or the mounting kit required to get your cooler on the new socket. Now the goodness doesn't stop there. They also include a massive tube of thermal paste, and I've tried this, it just compares pretty much identical to the MX4, so good stuff that they've included with it. And they even give you this thick metal badge, which is interesting because a lot of people include cheap decals. These guys are including a thick metal badge, which I've got on the Fractal Define R4 there. Now let's get on to business with the cooler itself. This bad boy is not only the biggest thing I've seen in terms of dimensions for an air cooler, but it's also the heaviest as well, weighing in at 1.3 kilos with both fans attached. Looking at the dimensions, however, we have 161 millimeters wide by 150 millimeters long by 164 millimeters tall. Also important to note there is RAM clearance. You've got up to 64 millimeters of clearance there for your RAM. And also this cooler can be mounted either vertically orientated or horizontally orientated. However, looking at the materials of the cooler itself, we have a copper base plate, which is nickel plated and gives off a mirror finish. That's attached to 6 heat pipes, which are also nickel plated. And then that was all attached to a heap of aluminium fins. So now it's time to move on to the part that you've all been waiting for, and we will just get the benchmarks pulled right up here. And the first benchmark I decided to do was the 5820K at 4.3 gigahertz at 1.25 volt, which I've tested all the other coolers around here. And it's good to see that the Noctua does beat out every other air cooler here by a little comfortable margin there, especially against the Assassin, which is its next best competitor. So it beat that by a whole 2 degrees whilst remaining really quiet as well. It is important to note, however, it did lose to the Captain 240 water cooler by about 4 degrees, though on a platform like the 5820K, which gives off a lot of heat, especially compared to your 4 cores, that's no surprise, as water does cool more efficiently than air. Now moving on to the 6600K, this is where things came really close. Like, there wasn't anything in this. I had to test this a few different times, but we see here the NH-D15 only lost to the water cooler by 2 degrees. However, it still beat out every other air cooler. It beat out the Assassin by 1 degree. So the NH-D15 is the king of the hill when it comes to air cooling. So now that leaves us to the final conclusion, where I'm going to talk about this cooler and everything that I like and some little things that I don't like about it. So let's get on with the actual build quality. This is the most impressive thing about the Noctua NH-D15. I mean, it was just amazing. From opening this thing to installing it, I couldn't critique one negative about this. That you can see that Noctua have just paid attention to detail in everything. Just even things like boxing everything up so neatly. And then the getting the cooler out and just seeing that it's perfect. And the fans mount easy. The fans are really quiet. You've got good thermal paste included. The manual is just so simple. And then you even get a screwdriver included to make it just a breeze of an installation. It's actually a tall one as well for screwing in the middle of the base plate, which was not a problem to screw in. So everything just made sense on this cooler, and I was just absolutely blown away by the build quality. However, let's move on now to the negative, or a negative, because there's only one negative thing that I can really think of with this cooler, and that is the sheer size. Now, when I got the Deepcool Assassin in, I thought that thing was massive, and it is massive, but this thing is even bigger than the Assassin, and it's just so big, in fact, that it doesn't even fit properly on my X99 motherboard in one orientation, that's facing horizontally. However, it does mount in a non-conventional way, the vertical way, which in the end is fine. It mounts on this Z170 absolutely fine in both orientations, but keep in mind it is just so big. So keep that in mind and know the specs of this cooler if you wish to mount it on your rig. Just to be sure, for instance, if someone's mounting it with conventional airflow going through the case, then they can't mount it horizontally, they may come into a little bit of a problem with their flow or their airflow in their case. So this leaves me with my final score of 4.75 stars out of 5 stars. Now, I wanted to give this thing 5 stars, but just that mounting problem caused me to drop off 0.25 of a star here, because everything else with this cooler is just simply phenomenal. Build quality, amazing. Fans, quiet. I mean, I didn't even have to go into my BIOS and put it on a silent profile, because at max speed, these things were really quiet anyway. So I was just completely blown away by every little detail that Noctua have paid attention to with the D15. So anyway guys, that's about it from me today. If you have any questions or comments about the NH-D15, then please drop a comment in the comment section below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you haven't already, hit that like button and subscribe to Tech Yes City for more tech news, reviews, and even gaming. Peace out for now, bye.